gospel through this message.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Can we just open our mouth and begin to appreciate the Lord? Thank you. Do you think you can really thank God enough for all he has been doing for us? For life, for safety, for provision, for promotion, for all his promises? No one can ever thank him enough. That is why the wise ones, we want to use their character, obedience, to show God that we are ready to do anything for you. We are ready to do anything. What do you want me to do? You know, when you look into the law of God, the perfect law of liberty, there are things normally you wouldn't have done, but to prove to God that you love him, Lord, I will forgive. Lord, I will overlook. Lord, I will bless those that are persecuting me. Lord, I will do this to show you how much I love you. That was the lifestyle of Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul said, I'm only living to see if that which I have done against God, I can be able at least to show that it was out of ignorance. I never knew. You know, praise the Lord. Masakate. Thank you, Lord. Thank you this morning for a wonderful day, a beautiful day you have given unto us. Lord, we ask, O God, that in everything be thou exalted and be thou magnified. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Can you quickly go with me to the book of Luke, chapter 16, from verse 19. It's a story that we know very, very well. But I want to bring out a topic from the teaching and see whether it will make sense to us. Shabaragada. Rebarambo Shambra Katuribaba. Luke chapter 16, from verse 19. To 28, 29, 10 verses.
Amen.
Yep.
Then I read Luke 16:19.
Yes.
There was a rich man.
There was a very rich man
who was dressed in purple and fine linen and live in luxury every day.
You see, linen is one of the dresses I'll be wearing when I'm very comfortable. It's very easy for me, you know? See here is clothes for the rich man. Kaftan, linen. I love it so much. You know, very costly.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, linen, you know? But the Bible says this man goes on purple every time and on linen. Linen. The last linen I had, I can't forget the picture. I can't forget the color. I'm always remembering and seeing it. But I've not had it for some time now. Yes. 20. There was a rich man, yeah?
20.
Mm-hmm.
At his gate was laid a beggar named Lazarus.
There was a beggar at his gate named Lazarus.
Covered with sores,
mm-hmm.
and longing to eat what fell from the rich man's table.
This Lazarus is not, Bible saying that none should be poor. It's not God's fault that he is poor. There are principles in the Bible, if you don't obey them, you will not get the benefit. Maybe he was a Christian that was not interested in sowing seed. Maybe he was a Christian, you know, all he gets. The Bible says when you get, you know, there are people that are stubborn. So it's for you to know that it's not going to stop you from going to hell. I mean, from going to heaven. Your lack of seed sowing, or it will make you be poor on earth. Does that make sense? Look at Lazarus. How will the, that is why the rich man did not repent. How will you want to repent to a God that people that are serving him is as poor as Lazarus? The Bible says he will bless you 100% on earth and 100% in heaven. So be careful so that you don't be a good Christian like Lazarus. That will be poor. Continue.
Amen. Even the dogs came and licked his soul.
Oh, Jesus.
22. The time came when the baker died.
And the time came. Now the story has changed its step. Okay?
And the angels carried him to Abraham's side.
You see, when the beggar died, and it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into a... Do you know why he was carried? Who can help me explain that, why he was carried instead of being buried? Yes? Why was he carried instead of being buried? And if after answering this question, I tell you my topic. Why is it that the beggar, Lazarus, died? And instead of being buried, he was carried by the angels into the bosom. And another thing I want you to understand about this story is true, is a real, is real story. Jesus was telling us a truth. He said, a certain man. Certain. William Shakespeare, he wanted to explain the word that this is of utmost certain. He said, certitude. So certitude means absolute certain, 100% certain. So Jesus said, he said, use the same word. He said, certain man. So why is it that when Lazarus died, instead of being buried like the rich man, he was carried? Yes?
Maybe it's in your top that he died to his flesh, something like that?
Because you've already had you got my topic. It's because he's dead. He was crucified with Christ when he was on earth. You only bury dead people. You don't bury somebody that is alive. In as much as the Bible said dead, but that death means expired. The same thing that will happen to us, the Bible says within a twinkle of an eye. For our own, it didn't say angels will carry us. He didn't explain it that way. Within a twinkle of an eye, immediately you die, pam, judgment follows. Why? So people will be wrong. That is why I'm not interested in you. The body you are carrying is an expired, just like where you are carrying poo-poo. So I don't see the reason why you should go and start buying $100,000 casket to bury poo-poo. Eh? What's the need? This is poo-poo. Poo-poo, you don't bury it. You just put it, rub it somewhere and throw it away when I die. Because you made a pump, the Bible says, within a trickle of fire. And nobody should make me, as I'm traveling, enjoying my going to heaven, and you make me to come back and slap you. When you're trying to spend money on my burial, why not use it to do something else? The people that should be buried are people like the rich man, people that are still alive. That's what I'm going to teach. That's my topic this morning. It's either you lose your flesh or you lose heaven. Let's continue to see what happened with the rich man, the spirits of the rich man.
Amen. The rich man also died and was buried.
23. A rich man also died and was what?
Buried.
See, one, when he was alive on earth, two of them were on earth, but one already died. To those that the end of this world had already come. I am crucified with Christ, it's no more me that lives, but Christ that lives. So when you die, what will happen? Angel will say, oh, Christ. Let's take Christ. Are you getting it now? What is it that Jesus had that you still have now? That everybody has? God bless you. That's Jesus is the firstborn. Jesus Christ, Idika Christ, Favor Christ. That's why the Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. He's alive. He's a living. His power. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower. And whenever you run into it, Christ is the kingdom of God. This man died. And he was not buried. Do you know why it was easy for the angels to carry him? He didn't have flesh, he was light. But if he had flesh, they would put him on the ground so that the flesh would remove. Are you getting it? So the rich man also died and he was buried. I pray that when you die, you will not be buried. You will be carried by angels. Am I making sense? Continue.
23. Mm-hmm. In Hades, where he was...
And in hell, that's hell, yes? Hades, yep.
Where he was tormented.
When he was tormented, you see? Now, it's only in Nigerian movie where when spirits are crossing the road, they will look. They are not real ghosts. They are not real spirits. A spirit doesn't feel bad. A spirit, that is why even devil will be there, nothing. Because the people that owns this earth is man. The earth he has given to sons of men. And the proof that you are a man is flesh. But your ability to lose your flesh during your journey on earth is what will determine where you will go. Remember, this is very true. It might not make sense to you, but it's very true on the last day you see it. You all were angels. Why is it that you are not behaving foolishly now? Why is it that we are behaving like human beings now? Because spirits, through your mother's womb, what you were doing there was they were tailoring your flesh for you. They were tailoring the suit that will fit you, called the body, the flesh. And this flesh is dead. There's no life in flesh. Everything about flesh is pointing towards death. 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 So, angel, that was life, and was now clothed with the body called death. Now, your journey on life, on earth, merely you discover yourself. Whom will I send? Isaiah remembered. And said, send me, Lord. Immediately you start going. Your priority should be to kill the flesh. Otherwise, you will not be released from this earth to hell. You will be taken to where people that have flesh goes. Where? Hell. If you are not on the process of losing your flesh, look at what happened. The rich man was on earth enjoying palace. No challenges of life. The Bible says, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. He was just living his life, building his flesh, entertaining his flesh. Look at what the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 6. Let's go there. 2 Corinthians, chapter 5.
Therefore, we are always confident.
We are always confident.
Knowing that, yes. Whilst we are at home in the body.
When we are comfortable in this body.
We're absent from the Lord.
You are far from God. I hope you are not close that to heaven. It's the Bible. Comparing scriptures with scriptures. You're living your life. Everything your flesh tells you to do, go and smoke cigarette, you go and smoke one packet. your church today, you say it's true, I have toothache. When pastor comes, I'll tell him toothache. But you don't know that when you stand up with that toothache, immediately you get to church, that toothache, if you are truly a believer, that toothache will run away. You see that toothache was just trying to pull you out. Last Sunday, my eyes, I can't even stand on this. I don't deal with things. I have coverage, I have insurance, I have health insurance, all this. I don't do that. First of all, I know I'm a spiritual man. So anything that happens to me starts from the spirit. I have to deal with it spiritually. I lay my hand upon my eyes and I decree. I say, God, no. This was something that I wasn't even supposed to go to walk with it. I mean, church with it. But when I came here, that was the healing. Before 3 or 4 days, it disappeared. I'm telling you the truth, it disappeared. So what happened that a part of my flesh died? Now look at the next verse.
For we walk by faith, not by sight.
Now if you compare the first verse 6 to verse 7, if you are comfortable in this body, you are far from where God. But if you are walking by faith, you are near to God. What does that mean? Mean this body will not be comfortable if you must walk by faith. That's what it means. You have to crush this body. What have I been doing? Somebody preached a message and said, we have destroyed our congregation with lies. Distorting the concept of grace. You don't need to do anything grace. You are killing them. See, there's no way you will ever see God without paying the price of wilderness experience. You must pass from Egypt to Canaan, Canaan to. And he was just mentioning small things that might happen to you. And God will say, overlook. Even in business, you lose money, God will say, overlook. He's testing you to know whether you depend on bread or you depend on the voice of the Lord. And before you finish that process, you see you will die. The next thing will be have an encounter with God. There are things God wants to share with us. But our position in life, our flesh cannot allow God to. You cannot allow us. We can't listen to it. Because flesh will be disturbing us. But sometimes, God, that is why we fast. When you want deeper thing, you go 40 days. To crush the flesh, so that you'll be 100% attentive to Jehovah. If you are close to God, if everything happened to you, let me tell you, listen to me very well. Throughout the week, your body is shining dry rice, what do you?
Dry rice?
Is it? No, there's a rice you fry the oil.
Jada rice?
What is a Liberian rice? What are the names of your rice is sauces? There's one. It's not potato leaf. It's not cassava leaf. It's not making what this moment. I'm talking, you know, you every day, every week, the whole week you are eating and your body shine. When you remove your clothes, your belly will be shining like oil. Check yourself by the way, you are far from God that week. I'm telling you the truth. But when you want to eat something and you didn't get it, the Bible says, consider. I've been giving you, now that you don't have, consider, there's something I want you to get. Consider. Sometimes you go and borrow money to make your belly shine. To eat dry rice or whatever you call it. That rice is sweet too. Just use tomatoes and... what do you do? Mommy used to cook it now, what do you call it? You've forgotten the name? So that is what I'm talking about. It's very true, it's very real. That is why when your body is too
comfortable, you start getting sick, moving you to death. Thank God for CGMi Global. Every first 3 days of, I wish you know important of it. All the things you have eaten throughout the month, all the shining belly food, with that 3 days fasting, you will crush it if you are faithful. Your system will restart, reset, start again. Every month, it's real. Because it's the flesh. There's something I noticed. I found few, all of them, they've disappointed us. They didn't disappoint us because, you know, there are some compromises. Look at, Buhari is dead. Adeboye is aware, a man of God. How do you explain it? Queen Elizabeth is aware. A sign of civilization. Ghana here, the president of Ghana is aware. African leaders are aware. Now a man of God that is supposed to speak out, that is 100% aware that Buhari is dead. He went, he confirmed it. His pastor that he gave to be assistant of Buhari, he knows that Buhari is dead. So why are they not saying they want this flesh to be alive? Am I making sense? They want this flesh to be alive. They don't want this flesh to die. And if the Bible is true, if Adeboye wants his flesh to be alive, to cover the lies, he knows Buhari is dead. He has God, he knows 100%. The Bible says it's far from God. I have found that I've located about two or three of people I know God have raised to replace all these mega ministers that want to be comfortable in their flesh. And one thing I discovered about them, they are all lanky. Because their faith is eating up and their teaching is awesome. The two-edged sword, they preach the two-edged sword. If you see them, I've not seen any one of them. Three of them I've discovered. I know genuinely that God is going to use them to bring back his glory in our world. Because their faith is eating their flesh. They are not comfortable. Every time, even in their messages, you find out. They have all everything everybody's looking for. When they start to teach the whole crowd, everybody will start crying. But nothing, they don't have flesh. You don't, their flesh is not shining. It's only you see the glory of God. So we have to be very, very careful. Look at it. Unless you lose your flesh on earth, I'm telling you, you will lose heaven. Make your choice today. To crush your flesh or lose heaven or say heaven. I prefer my flesh, you like the rich man. Anything, you know, he will be answering call. I will be eating his chicken, talking, you know. Who is that man there? Dog, go out, thank you. The Bible says he'll be waiting for what will be thrown to the dog. And dog will now, because he saw, the dog has already filled their tummy. They don't need, so they lick salt, he saw. He said, be eating our bone, let's be licking, drinking the soft drink from your body. Let's finish that one. Look.
Amen. Mm-hmm. In Hades, where he was in torment, mm-hmm. he looked up and saw Abraham far away with Lazarus.
With Lazarus!
By his side,
mm-hmm.
24.
Mm-hmm.
So he called to him.
He called to him.
Father Abraham, have pity on me,
mm-hmm.
and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue.
And cool my tongue! His body is still alive. That's why he's in there. Your body cannot be alive and you'll be in heaven. As long as your body is still alive, you will see it. There's something that debates. Anyone that's stiff, yeah, read, continue.
Because I'm in agony in this fire.
In this fire, fire is burning. Mm. Spirit doesn't, there's no fire. It's only Nigeria moving spirit that fire burns. Spirit fire doesn't burn spirit.
Continue. Amen. 25.
Mm-hmm.
For Abraham replied.
Abraham replied.
Son,
mm-hmm.
remember that in your
lifetime. In your lifetime, you refused to kill your flesh.
You received your good things.
You were giving your flesh good things.
While Lazarus received bad things.
While Lazarus was dealing with his flesh. I can't compromise. Mm-hmm. I can't lie. I can't. He said, I perish. If I perish, I perish. And he was losing his flesh. You were giving your flesh good things. Lazarus was giving his own flesh evil things. Continue.
But now.
Now!
He is comfortable here.
He has passed through, penetrated the barrier. Because he had no flesh again. He was a spirit when he died.
And you are in agony.
You are in agony.
26.
Uh-huh.
And beside of all this, between us and you.
And beside all that, between us and you.
A great chisme.
There's a gulf, there's a covenant, there's something that cannot allow anybody that wears flesh to pass through.
Has been set in place
mm-hmm.
so that those who want to go from here to you cannot.
Yes.
Nor can anyone cross over from there to us.
Mm-hmm.
27.
Yes.
He answered, then I begged you.
Yes.
Father, send Lazarus to my family.
Mm-hmm.
28.
Yes.
For I have five brothers.
I have five brothers.
Let him warn them.
Let him warn them.
So that they will not also come to this place of torment.
So that they kill their flesh. Lazarus died because he was light. Actually, he just floated. It wasn't just the angel took him. He went to where he belonged. Righteousness makes you light. Don't you see it? Don't you see when you living in obedience with Christ, you're always happy, joyful? Don't you see it when you follow the will of God? In within you, you feel that you have achieved, you are achieving something in life. Don't worry, on the last day. On the last day, we know who is who. We know. I don't know how I can ever in life. Let me tell you, one of the greatest things that's ever happened to me is God healing my kidney, liver, destroying the spirit of diabetes. I'm telling you the truth. I was supposed to be a dead man 1996, 97, 98. How many years now? I wish I was the answer when they wanted. They say if you don't shave your hair for about, they will kill you. I was supposed to die 52 years ago. So if I had lived the extra 52, dying now wouldn't be, I would regret it. That's one of the things that has made, because through those situations I saw God. Through those situations I became brave, no fear. Through those situations, I had an encounter with Jehovah. And the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 30, can you get it? Proverbs chapter 30. Say it will be medicine to your life. We start from 5. Proverbs chapter 30, verse 5 to 7. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. That's the medicine that I need now. Yes.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Uh-huh.
And lean not unto thine own
understanding. Don't lean on your indica. Don't lean on what you are seeing on Google. Don't lean on what you have been taught in school. Don't lean on your understanding. Continue. In all your ways.
In all thy ways, acknowledge him.
Uh-huh.
And he shall direct thy path.
Now what would verse 7 do to you?
Be not wise in thy own eyes.
Be not wise in your own eyes.
Fear the Lord.
Fear the Lord.
And depart from evil.
And 8.
It shall be health to thy neighbor.
It shall be medicine. It shall be medicine.
And marrow to thy bones.
Are you getting it now?
Yes.
Oh, you don't know. Have you seen me as somebody that enjoy trouble, suffering, affliction? I enjoy it. It's because of this reason. Because these are the only thing that can kill and crush your flesh. As you are joining on this earth, all those things have been destroyed. If I tell you the risk I have taken in life on behalf of people, and they were afraid, I said, don't worry. You are a Christian. I'm a Christian brother. Okay, I'm your youth pastor. Okay, don't worry about this. I'll go and do it for you. Just like one lady that they gave, in Nigeria, you know, they want to, the lecturers want to, you know, have the ladies. So it happened that one girl, because she refused the lecture, the lecturer gave her their project, their end of the year, I mean, end of course project. Gave her to go to, you have to travel on the water for 3 hours. So I was her youth president. And when she brought that to the church, I said, I'll go. I'll go. I don't know how to swim. I went. I was on water. In the night, in the hotel, I was sleeping. See pastors in the dream. Pastors dressed very well. They dressed very well. They came in the dream. And they said, oh, Pastor Joseph, thank God for your life. So you came to visit us. I was rejoicing. I thought they were fellow pastors. They said, we are going to do anything you want us to do. But one thing, do not do it. Do not preach. Do not preach. Huh? In the dream, my fellow pastors, they came. And I said, Pastor Joseph, thank God you came. We know we've had your testimony. We have your bread. We have this, that. But we want to beg you, in this place, don't preach. Eh? In the dream. And I said, because if I had not preached, have you not forgotten? Have you forgotten? The book of Romans, what it says? What did it say in 16 verse 6? Can somebody read it? Romans 15 verse 16 verse 6.
Romans?
Mm-hmm.
Greet Mary whom...
Is that Romans?
Yeah.
6:16, that is 6:16.
Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servant? Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servant to obey?
You see the principle in the word of God. So when they came in the dream and said, if you, they were looking for a way for me to yield, it was demon, it was devil. He wanted me to yield to his instruction, not to preach. You see everything I need. You came here, you came here to get one of your youth members. Sign. We will do everything for you, but don't preach. If I accept it, you will see I will sink in that river. You know what I did? The man that understood the principles in the word of God, that knows what I went in the morning, I went to the to their because they have a river where they worship their goddess. I went direct. I didn't go for the program again because the guy that was going to help me do that, I've already paid him. He has already finished filling it. I was supposed to go and pick it and go home. I said, no, this time you came to, I will tell, because the only way for me to break away from that course is to be disobedient. If I am obedient, I'm a servant to them. Whatever they say will come out. I went to that river where they were, you will see where they were worshiping. I started shouting, this God is not real. I said, do you know the funny part of it? I don't even know how to swim. So go and tell this your God that somebody that doesn't know how to swim will be traveling on this river for 3 hours. And I said, if that God, that your God, try to sink me and walk upon the waters. I said, go and tell that I don't know how to swim. If you want, I'll show you now. But I'm going to travel on this river, on this for 3 hours. If that God tried to tell you that God is not real. If it is a lady, is a woman. If she tried it, go and tell her. I walk upon the waters. And many will give their life to Christ. A man that is facing death, A man had the hole is river. I can't take car. There's no way car will take me back to Aba. Archbishop said, it's a risk to take risk, but it's riskier when you don't take. Do you know what happened? When I went picked, played the guy, picked out, I was going home. As I was entering the boat, everybody was looking at me. All the people, they were looking at me. I said, God bless you. Go and tell that your goddess you're worshiping, that she's nothing. I'm here to prove to you that she's nothing. I don't know how to swim. Let her come and capsize my boat. I'm just taking another project for God. Because you're as wealthy as the responsibilities you're willing. Why did I take it? Because I was accused that why I'm helping Malaysia is because I have a strange attack. I say, I will show you now. You think if you tell me that, I will leave the work God has called me to do? When we go to heaven, we see who has strange attack and who doesn't have strange attack. I said, then I'm going to buy the hall for them. I'm going to buy the hall for them. I don't care. I was praying for Nam the cow. And the thing that came into my mind, the picture that came into my mind that was revealed to me is that this guy, anytime he moves, it's not about, anytime he stands up to move, say there's a cloud of pillar that follows him by day, a cloud of fire by night. The picture was, he is the one. If you want to change, if you want to shake the world, immediately he moves, the pillar follows him. But if he doesn't move, or fear of what people are saying, he will remain in that place. That's how I am. It's only what I do not want to do. It's only what I've not made the choice to do that I do not achieve. I've never, I'm yet to remember what I want to achieve that I have not achieved. Wanted to do a women's convention here. The lady that stopped it, I said, this is the only project in life. This is the only convention I want to do in life that has been stopped. You. So how do you think I will ever do anything with you again? For my first time, I came in agreement with you to do something. And I wanted to do a convention in Australia here. And because I got into a relationship with you, it will remind the people you get into covenant with you. Are you living your life on earth? Are you killing your flesh? Or are you giving your flesh, you know? That is why when death appears, I say, this is an opportunity to kill my flesh more. When challenges appear, when there is anything, I say, this is an opportunity for me to kill my flesh. A man that doesn't kill his flesh, do you know what will happen to him? Apostle Paul, as great as he was, as anointed as he was, look at what happened in Romans. Get me Romans, chapter 7. 15, from verse 15.
For that which I do, I allow not.
For that which I do, I see myself doing what I don't want to do.
For what I would, that do I not.
But what I want to do, I don't do.
For what I hate, that do I.
What I hate is what I do. Why? Flesh. He was feeding his flesh. In my workplace, I have somebody that, when they had somebody came and, this man is a pastor. He's one of the pastors we respect in Australia here. The next shift I had with the guy, in the morning, we say, I don't want you to come into the office, please. I said, why? We are working, though. If you are working with all these white ladies, they report you immediately, you've lost your job. So I don't want you to come. I said, why? So I want to meditate. When I finish meditating, you can come in. Okay. Not doing anything. I'm telling you, before the next 30 minutes, what I've got. I keep quiet. The other day, he told me he had food poisoning. I said, open your meditation. Open your meditation. You can't meditate to meditate out there. I said, I cannot have food poisoning. I said, even my children, I cannot because of my children, maybe they say they've died. I will leave my job. I will be here and command them, they will come back to life. She, huh? How do you do all those things? Is it because you don't drink? He said, yes, no, it's not because I don't drink. Don't drink is for me to give full revelation of what God is saying. Is it because you don't smoke? I said, no. He said, I told him, I'm a spirit. Because I've crossed the flesh. The flesh is no more alive. The flesh doesn't dictate to me any longer. So they're looking at him. I think this time around, because it just happened last week, the shift we're going to start this week, maybe it's going to now meditation is 1 hour. Now it's going to be 3 hours. I said, are you still meditating? This is science. I'm telling you, this is science. It's not revelation. People call it, they came and gave it the name. They changed the name from energy to chi. He's generating chi. He's generating chi energy. And when they hear that God used you to do a miracle, they say, oh, you focus your chi on somebody and he was healed. This is science. Science is not. Church, I don't know whether I've made sense. Paul said, for me to live is Christ and to die is gain. So it's no more me that lives, but Christ that lives in me. Let's see how the process of how this flesh can be crushed. Quickly, then it's a long place, a long, then we finish it, then we'll close. Go to 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Start from verse 5. You will understand when the light shines in your heart, God has caused it to shine. You see, things will start, the enemy will come. And when the enemy is doing that, the foolish ones will say, I'm suffering, this one, I'm not going to make it. Christianity is a lie. But the wise one will know, the spirit is coming out alive, while the flesh is being destroyed. Here, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, from verse 5. And we're going to close with that. I'm closing my Bible now.
We do not proclaim ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord.
Yeah.
And ourselves as
you. You see, when you start preaching Jesus and not yourself, look at what will happen. Look at what will start happening in your life.
And ourselves as your slaves for Jesus' sake.
Yes.
For God, who said, let light shine out of darkness.
Yes.
Is the one who shines in our hearts.
He will shine his light in your heart. If you stop preaching yourself and start preaching Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he will cause his light to shine in your, from you. Continue. And immediately that light comes, look at what the world will do to you.
To give us the light of the glorious knowledge of God in the face of Christ. But we have this...
this treasure in earthly vessel, yes?
In clay jars, so that the extraordinary power belongs to God.
Now you see, what will be happening now will be to destroy the clay, so that the treasure in you will come out. English language, we call it potentials. So that what? The flesh will die. Continue.
And it does not come from us.
Mm-hmm.
We are experiencing trouble on every side.
We experience, you start experiencing trouble from every side.
But I'm not crushed.
But you can never be crushed. Why? The spirit in you, the real you, cannot be crushed.
We are perplexed.
We will be confused, perplexed, as if not knowing what to do. But the one in you can never be perplexed. Continue.
We're not driven to despair.
But we cannot be despaired.
We're persecuted.
We will be persecuted.
We're not abandoned.
All these things are happening so that your flesh will die. In then you get the right mentality, the positive mentality that God is removing something that I don't need in my life. That's the same thing when God passed through fire. The death and the God will go away. I mean, there's something I'm learning every day, every time we travel to Malaysia. My wife will gather all our gold. If you see the color, I'm telling you, if you see the color, heat and this stuff. Do you know they will price the gold, no matter the color, the same price they are pricing, giving us the one that is shining. I'm telling you the truth. They will price the gold. One kg is $250. Okay, what we're having here is 40 kg. What you're giving us is 40 kg. But the one you've picked now is 50 kg. Are you getting it? They'll calculate it. 250 times 40 kg. Then they know the price. Then they'll calculate 240 times 50 kg. Then they'll give us the balance. I say your balance to pay if you want this one. Don't lose this value. We travel to Malaysia 2018. When we go again, we'll do the shelter. You wouldn't lose the value because they know you're just putting it in the fire, bam, every day. Can't lose this value, you just need the fire. So that's what the fire will pass, fire of affliction. Continue.
We're knocked down. We're not destroyed.
Yes.
Always carrying around in our body the death of Christ.
Yes.
Jesus. So that the life of Jesus
will be made manifest. Yeah.
May also be made visible in our bodies.
Mm-hmm.
For we who are alive are constantly being handed over to death.
Why? Why are we being constantly handed over to death? Because we are spirit. You just want the flesh to die, to demarcate us, to separate us from the flesh. So when you run away from challenges, when you run away from battles, I'm just teaching my children something now. Thank God for coronavirus. When coronavirus came, it reduced us. It took us to a place where, I'm telling you, most people will not survive it. Anytime my wife would tell me, you are suffering too much. I say, what? I'm not. I'm teaching my children, is it? I'm teaching my children not to depend on the government. I'm teaching my children to depend on Jehovah. That the first reason why I'm doing this is to show my children. They know all our situation because you know when they are praying, they mention all the challenges we're having. So they know. God bring us back to surplus. God bring us back to surplus. And this is ordinarily what people cannot do. I said, I'm not going to government to say remove this debt. I cannot, because immediately they remove that debt, your name has entered as people that when you want money tomorrow, they will not give you. You think they are joking? Say, I can't, I'll pay the money. And as I'm talking to you today, the next statement of account that is going to come, you'll see testimony we have overcome. Amen. I don't know what I'm doing for my children. I don't know their situation tomorrow. The world is decaying. I will not be there. But if they remember the God of their father, that helped their father to come out of that challenge, they will hold on to that God. The Bible calls him a stronghold in time of trouble. See, that's the reason why I'm doing it. We are crushed down. The one in you cannot be destroyed, no matter what is happening. He that is in me is greater than he that is in the world. But when you allow every situation, you say, God, what do you want me to learn? You are destroying the flesh. For the spirit, for the treasure to be made alive. Continue.